And we'll look to come to green next time by 10 laps to get in the top five, racing their way in. Standridge in the 56, McConnell in the 119, in charge of the start. That last tire there off of turn number four. Eyes on them, Boyd Speedway. They'll get ready to pull the trigger, smash a loud pedal. Green's out, and here we go. Car's out of shape, hang on. Three cars involved here. See Robbie Moses' machine sitting sideways on the main time, and here we go. Down into turn number one, Mike McConnell rolls the outside. He'll go to the race lead. Hickson's going to be in second. Tommy Taylor goes to third. Robbie Moses fourth. Moses, though, getting some pressure. We got one car involved there. And caution flag's going to wave. Robbie Moses around in turn number four. Here, green flag in the air, and here we go. McConnell will lead him off, two down the back straight away. Hickson second, Taylor third, Johnson fourth, Roland in a fifth. And Roland looking to get fourth, put the double deuce into the fourth spot, move Josh Johnson back to fifth, and he'll try to keep the J8, a fellow Winchester Speedway regular, Jaden Frame behind him now. Meanwhile, up front, the 119 of Ballground, Georgia's of Mike McConnell showing a way out in front. McConnell's the leader. Jody Hickson rides in second. Tommy Taylor third. Will Rowland fourth. Has Josh Johnson in the J1, the J8 of Jaden Frame, trying to duke it out for that fifth and final transfer position with four laps in the books, one lap shy of the halfway signal. And we're going to see the halfway indicator right here. The cross sticks out. Five down, five to go here in Super Late Model. Last chance. Heat number one, and it is all Ballground, Georgia's Mike McConnell out in front of this one. Jody Hickson is second. Tommy Taylor third. Will Rowland fourth. Josh Johnson in fifth. Again, the top five transfer on. First man on the outside looking in right now from that sixth position is the J8 of Jaden Frame. We'll have lap seven going up on the Boyd Speedway scoreboard there. Turn number three, three to go. Three to go here in this one. As they work down the back straightaway, get ready to see the two lap to go signal right here. Two to go being shown to the field by Chief Starter Wesley Womack. And it is all Mike McConnell out in front here with less than two laps remaining in last chance B main heat number one. And we got caution. Caution is out as the 22 of Will Rowland's machine. He was in a transfer spot, was running fourth, and that car has come up lame up on the top side of turn number two. We'll see if Graysville, Tennessee native Jody Hickson's got anything for him here on this restart. Green, white, checkered will settle it. McConnell will bring them down here off turn number four. Green's in the air. Two laps to settle it. Here we go. McConnell will lead them off two down the back straight away. Taylor trying to pressure Hickson for the second spot down into turn three as the white flag waves. One lap's going to settle it. As they race through turns one and two, Taylor looks to the inside of Hickson. They make contact. McConnell's going to win this one, but it's still in doubt for second as they work off turn number four. Ballground Georgia's Mike McConnell will be the winner with Jody Hickson coming on in the runner-up spot. Tommy Taylor will finish in third. Hickman and Miller, the veteran and the youngster on the front row of this one. Raleigh Hickman, four-time and defending Southern All-Star Series champion, veteran racer, and the youngster, 13-year-old Carter Miller out of Salem, Virginia, the 2016 Natural Bridge Virginia Speedway track champion, will bring them to green. Here off turn number four. Green's out. Here we go. But I'm off into turn number one. Hickman's going to have the lead. Miller going to roll into the second position. On the main straightaway. I'm assuming maybe they were saying that since all that got started prior to them taking the green flag is the reason why that took place. Now we'll come green. See what happens this time. Everyone by the flag stand cleanly and safely as Hickman will lead them into turn one off of turn two. Miller going to be in second. Carver third. Tankersley in a fourth. And a Bowles going to be in fifth here on the opening lap of this one. And sixth is going to be the G9 of Eric Granger as Riley Hickman sporting a 525 power plant. Oh, they've tangled in turn one. We've got them tangled on both ends of the racing surface. Stacy Bowles is involved in a spin up in turn one. Caution lights are out. We'll try it again right here. Riley Hickman bringing the field down. And young Carter Miller right on his back bumper. Green back at it. Here we go. See how things shake out here now. Hickman will lead him down the back straightaway. Granger way out of shape. Has slid up and made contact with the outside wall in turn two. Caution flag is out once again. And Granger will pull the G9 machine into the infield. Looks like his day is going to be finished. As we'll now get ready to come back to green, Riley Hickman pulls the trigger on him, and here we go. Hickman leads him down the back straightaway with Carter Miller second, Dusty Carver third, Shane Tankersley fourth, Stacy Bowles fifth, Clayton Turner first man on the outside. Look at it right now. He rides in the sixth spot. Get the top five transferring on. Oh, car's out of shape. The three of Clay Joseph into the infield. He has spun down out of the way and looks like we will stay green. Here's Joseph's machine down into the infield area as young Carter Miller starting to put the pressure on Riley Hickman. The youngster will look to the inside of Hickman down the back straightaway and into turn number three. As we get close to the halfway point of this one, Hickman the leader, Miller is second, Carver third. Tankersley is fourth, Bowles is fifth. Hickman drifts a bit again off two. That opens the door for Miller. Once again, we'll take a look to the inside of Hickman and in three, but Hickman will close the door on him as they work off turn number four to the halfway signal. Five down, five to go. And Miller trying to get racy with the veteran. He is the youngster. Here he comes, working beneath Riley Hickman. They're side by side down the back straightaway and into turn number three. Hickman in the middle. Miller on the bottom off of turn four. The 13-year-old out of Virginia has gone to the lead. Carter Miller goes to the point. Riley Hickman now in second. Dusty Carver third. Shane Tankersley fourth. Stacy Bowles fifth. But your leader's going to encounter some slower traffic before the conclusion of this one. So we'll see how the youngster handles working slower traffic here. As the first car he's going to have to negotiate is going to be the three of Thomas Watson. And Miller slips up a bit. That may open the door for Hickman to retake the race lead as Miller's machine may be having problems here in the waning laps of this one. Oh, man. Hickman now back on the point with Carver in second, Tankersley third. Miller going to lose the fourth spot to Stacy Bowles. And Miller now back to fifth. Can he hang on here on the final lap as they race down the back straightaway for the final time? Hickman contact with Watson off of turn number four. Riley Hickman will be your winner. I believe Shane Tankersley going to come home in second there. Dusty Carver going to finish in the third spot. Stacy Bowles will be fourth, and Carter Miller will hang on to finish fifth. Good race action there between Hickman and salute you, the great race fans here at Boyd Speedway. So we need everyone in the house. Warm yourself up a minute. Get up there. Jump up and down. Wave your arms, hands, and caps to your favorite driver. And wish them Godspeed for the next 40 laps here in the 9th annual Cabin Fever 40. It's the Schaefer Oil Ironman Championship Super Late Model Series here at Boyd Speedway. Race fans, here they are. And once we get out of the four wide formation, they will let them break out and get just a little bit of heat in the tires before we bunch them up two by two double file, just like Noah took the animals on the ark and bring them to green. As the one to go signal's being shown, and race fans, we're coming to green next time. Bye.
Shannon Buckingham, who picked up a win at Tri-County in 2016 with the Southern National Series, looking to possibly get a win with the Schaefer's Ironman Series here tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's showtime. We're underway. Into turn number one, Ogle and Buckingham battle for the lead. Billy Ogle Jr. comes out of there with the top spot. Shannon Buckingham going to be in the second position here in the opening lap of this one. Ogle will lead them through on lap number one. David Brandon up to third. John Owen be battling with Derek Ellis. That's for the fourth spot. And we got a caution. Caution is out. Three cars tangle here exiting turn number four. So take two on this one. Buckingham and Billy Ogle Jr. will bring them to green off forward. Here we go. Buckingham going to jump to the race lead this time. Billy Ogle Jr. will be in second. Justin Litchford going to be third. John Owen be fourth. David Brandon at fifth here as they work the opening lap of this one. And Brandon trying to work beneath Owenby for fourth, but not able to get it done. Dale McDowell rides in the sixth position. Derek Ellis is seventh. Austin Horton eighth. Ray Cook ninth. Here on the opening lap of this one, Mark Page is tenth. And Page about to get the ninth spot away from Cook. He'll have that done as we've got two in the books. And Shannon Buckingham showing the way out in front in that number 50 machine. Billy Ogle Jr. rides in position number two. And we got three cars tangled down in turn number two. Caution, flag is out. Showing the way here out in front with two laps official. He'll bring them back to green flag. Billy Ogle Jr., Justin Litchford, John Owenby, and David Brennan in tow. Bring them back to green, and here we go. Buckingham with a great launch off that start. Put several car lengths on Billy Ogle Jr. here on the opening lap of this restart to put lap number three up on the board. Ogle Jr. in second, Litchford third. Owenby in a position number four with Brandon in position number five. Yes, Buckingham looking good out in front. We got a car spun down in the center of turn one and two, and that is Mike McConnell's 119 machine around in the center of turn one and two. And picked up one win in Southern Nationals competition, trying to get 2017 underway with a victory, and he'll bring them back to green. Here we go. Buckingham working out of back straightaway once again with a good start. Pulls away from Billy Ogle Jr., who holds down the second position. Justin Litchford will remain in third. John Owenby rides in the fourth position with David Brandon in the fifth. Dale McDowell sixth. Derek Ellis seventh. Austin Horton eighth. Mark Page ninth. Ray Cook sets in the 10th spot. Is everyone trying to stay in that sweet spot right around the bottom of the racing surface? That is the preferred line through the corners right now. Nobody wanting to jump off the bottom to try to make a move. And again, we stay green when we get into traffic. It's going to be interesting to see how things are going to play out up front. As Buckingham in the 50 and the 201 of Billy Ogle Jr. trying to work, put some distance on the third place car of Justin Litchford, the number four machine. Young man who turned a lot of heads with his time trial effort here this afternoon. Put that car into the lock-in, starting in the top five, and he sits in third right now with eight laps in the books. A fifth of the way home, eight down, up 32 to go. And we stay green. We got two cars tangled up in turn three and four, and that's going to bring out the caution flag. Looks like the 119 of Mike McConnell and the J8 of Jaden Frame have tangled down in turn number four. Miller and McConnell as we get ready to come back to green. Eight laps officially in the books, 32 remain. Green's back out from Wesley Womack, and here we go. Buckingham again with a good start, gets a good run off turn two down the back straightaway. It's about four car lengths on second place running Billy Ogle Jr. as we start to approach the one quarter mark of this Cabin Fever 40A main event. Buckingham leading the way. Ogle Jr. second. Litchford third. OMB fourth. And Brandon fifth as we're a quarter of the way home right there. 10 in the books. 30 remain. And again, you got to ask yourself what's going to happen if we stay green long enough. If they get to traffic, business could definitely pick up at the point, and it may do it before that. Is Billy Ogle Jr. in the 201 trying to close in on a race leader Shannon Buckingham as they race off turn two down the back straightaway. Buckingham, a former top five finisher in the World 100, showing the way here with the multi-time Tazewell Speedway track champion Billy Ogle Jr. nipping at his heels. And Buckingham's machine a little loose in the center of one and two. Ogle thought about taking a run, but drops back in behind him as they race into turn number three there. As we've got a baker's dozen, a lucky 13 in the books now. Shannon Buckingham and Billy Ogle Jr. trying to drive away from third place running Justin Litchford at this point and try to settle this thing amongst themselves as they put another lap on the board. They race through turns one and two. Buckingham's machine appears to be a little loose in one and two. The car starting to maybe loosen up a bit here as the race goes on. And don't know if that's going to be a good or a bad thing. We'll just have to wait and see what happens for Buckingham. Billy Ogle Jr. right there on him in the second spot. And Justin Litchford now in the number four. He's starting to gain ground on that front two just a bit as John Owenby holds down that fourth spot still. David Brandon rides in fifth. Dale McDowell is sixth. Derek Ellis seventh. Austin Horton eighth. Mark Page ninth and Ray Cook the final car in the top 10. Battle for the lead, but we got a caution. Caution is out as Donald McIntosh has slowed up in turn number four. Oh my. Billy Ogle Jr. was about to make a run for the lead right there. David Brandon fifth. 17 in the books. 23 remain, just about to the halfway mark of this one. Billy Ogle Jr. had flexed some muscle right there prior to that green. Let's see what happens here on this restart. Buckingham again able to scoot away from the field. As we'll put lap number 18 up, let's see if Billy Ogle may take him a couple of laps to get the heat built back up in the tires and make a run on Buckingham as he was doing prior to that last caution flag waving. One lap shy of the halfway point this time by Buckingham, the leader. Billy Ogle Jr. still second. Justin Litchford third. John Owenby fourth. David Brandon fifth. Dale McDowell sixth. Derek Ellis seventh. Austin Horton eighth. Ray Cook now ninth. And James Williamson is tenth. And we got caution. And the caution flag waves as the car slowed. That's Mark Page slowed up in turn number two. And eyes on them as they'll pull the trigger off to number four. And here we go. Buckingham with a good restart that time. Got a good run on the start there off turn number four. And we're going to come to the halfway signal right here. We'll have 20 down, 20 to go. This time by halfway to the house in the ninth annual Cabin Fever 40. Buckingham on the point. Billy Ogle Jr. second. Justin Litchford third. John Owenby fourth. David Brandon is fifth. Dale McDowell holds down the sixth spot. Derek Ellis is seventh. Austin Horton eighth. Ray Cook ninth. James Williamson, the Ival Kentucky native, in the final spot in the top 10. But now he's going to lose 10th to the R1 of former Cabin Fever 40 winner Riley Hickman. And he'll lose 11th to Shane Takersley. Drop Williamson back to 12th as Billy Ogle Jr. starting to make a move here on Shannon Buckingham up in front and possibly get a run on the leader. Buckingham real good off turn number four that time. And Ogle, though, he's better off turn two. Ogle trying to look to the inside, but he'll fall back in line. Continuing to turn laps just a tick quicker than the leader at this point. Buckingham and Ogle once again trying to get away from third place running Justin Litchford and try to settle this thing amongst themselves as there'll be 15 to go this time by at the line. 15 to go for Shannon Buckingham. Buckingham's machine appears to work better through turns three and four, but Billy Ogle Jr.'s mount better through turns one and two at this point in the race with 14 to go. Buckingham, whose car has loosened up a bit since the beginning of the race. You see him sliding them back tires just a bit. You got to wonder, will the rubber hold up? Is he abusing his tires a bit as Billy Ogle Jr. once again closes it in on Buckingham? He'll look beneath him off turn two. They're side by side for the lead down into turn number three. But Buckingham will close the door on Ogle as they work off turn number four with 12 to go. And that action let Justin Litchford roll it on the front two as well, as we've got 11 to go this time by. This one may not be over yet. Ogle again with a nice run off the bottom of turn two. Looks to the inside of Buckingham, but Buckingham's going to close the door. And these two better keep their eyes on Justin Litchford as he's closed in on the rear bumper of Billy Ogle Jr. And we got a car slowing up at the top of turn one and two. And caution flag is out. Caution is out. Mike McConnell's 119 slows, and we've got 10 to go. And it got gained ground on the front two. As Buckingham bringing them to green here off of turn number four with 10 to go, and we're back on. Buckingham leads them down the back straightaway once again. Billy Ogle Jr. still second, Justin Litchford third, John Owen be fourth. David Brandon is fifth, as we've got 9 to go. Buckingham and Ogle putting a little distance now between themselves and the four of Justin Litchford. It's getting about time to put your cards on the table as we're four-fifths of the way home. 32 of the 40 scheduled laps in the books, 8 remaining. And Buckingham starting to push his machine just a little bit harder here in the later going and try to scoot away from Billy Ogle Jr. With less than 7 to go now. Buckingham keeping Ogle Jr. at bay. And at this point on the transponders, Buckingham's machine is faster. You got to wonder, maybe he was saving a little bit here for the end of the race. As these two start to put a distance once again between himself and third place Litchford, as we'll have 5 to go this time by at the line. Buckingham and Billy Ogle Jr. going to try to settle the issue amongst themselves. As they work down the back straightaway and into turn number three, there'll be 4 laps to go this time by off turn number four. 4 to go, and we got caution out. Caution is out. Can Buckingham keep Billy Ogle Jr. behind him for the final few laps of this one? We'll see here off turn number four, and here we go. We'll have 4 to go this time by Shannon Buckingham, 4 laps away from victory here at Boyd Speedway. Work it off turn number 2 down the back straightaway. Billy Ogle Jr. doing everything he can to get a run on Buckingham, but not able to do it at this point, as we'll have 3 to go this time. 3 to go for the race leader, Shannon Buckingham. He and Billy Ogle Jr. going to settle it amongst themselves. Justin Litchford in third. John Owen be fourth. David Brandon fifth. As we'll see the 2 to go signal right here. 2 laps remain. Shannon Buckingham driving down the back straightaway for the next to last time. He'll work off turn number 4 to the white flag from Wesley Womack. 1 lap to settle it in the 9th annual Cabin Fever 40. Off turn 2, your leader works for the final time. Billy Ogle Jr. going to try to make 1 more run at him into 3, but to no avail. Shannon Buckingham will be the winner of the 9th annual Cabin Fever 40. Billy Ogle Jr. comes home second. Justin Litchford will be third. John Owen will be fourth. And David Brandon completes the top 5.
And gentlemen, getting the safety equipment off. And he's about to climb out of the car. Race fans, and let him know you appreciate him. Out of Morristown, Tennessee, winner of the Schaefer Ironman Championship Super Late Model Series 9th Annual Cabin Fever 40, it's Shannon Buckingham. Young man, congratulations. First thing I got to ask you, that caution come out on lap 17, is it one of them deals that it's sometimes better to be lucky than good? Because Ogle had a good run on you right there and looked like he may be going to sneak by you for the lead, but the caution came out. He had been up on the stopwatch on the transponders. He'd been anywhere between 1,500ths and 0.2 of a second faster than you prior to that.
Yeah, definitely the luck played into my favor right there. I just, man, this creeping around the bottom was getting to me. I felt like I needed to send it in there. I mean, the car's really good getting in, but, you know, if you miss that patch of rubber coming off, obviously you guys saw what happened. I missed it twice, once down here and probably let him get on me, and then I missed it down here in 3 and 4. My crew guy, JC, and then Matt with Hoosier, they were both up there going, you know, telling me to slow down. So it was a lesson in discipline just to try to, you know, to slow down to, you know, keep the car on the bottom, maybe go a little faster. But anyway, appreciate Billy for driving me clean. I'm sure he probably could have darned me around any corner down there. I really appreciate that. So definitely be giving that back to him the next opportunity. I like to race clean. I really appreciate it when somebody does me the same.
And talk about that there. One of them deals, you kind of had to slow down to get faster, because when we was announcing the race there, we noticed it looked like the car might have been loosening up on you a little bit. Was that a combination of maybe you overdriving the corner on entry there just a little bit, and then you finally kind of got settled down? Because the last 10 laps on the stopwatch, you were faster than second place at that point.
Yeah, definitely. You know, for the first 4 or 5 laps, the car was great. I felt like I could push, and then it got to a point where it started giving up on me. And, you know, I didn't know if I was missing my marks a little bit. You know, first race of the season, we've been off 2 or 3 months. So I didn't know if I was missing my marks. And to make up for that, I just started pushing harder. You know, and I think the tires probably were overheated maybe just a little and getting a little bit greasy. So, you know, definitely caution came out at the perfect time, let me regroup and attack it at a different direction and slow down. And I think, you know, I don't think we ever did pull out on him, but I think we definitely got more consistent. So, yeah, definitely happy to be lucky tonight.
No, you got some sponsors you want to thank. We'll let you do that here and let these photographers get your picture made, sir.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Roger Sellers at Tennessee RV, man, he funds this whole deal. He's a great sponsor, great friend. We've just had a blast. You know, we started this deal in March last year, and it's just been wonderful roller coaster ever since. You know, we've just had a blast. I got a teammate, Robbie, had a little bit of bad luck tonight in the Conti, but he'll be back for 411 here in a couple of weeks, and we'll be running strong. But yeah, want to thank all these sponsors on the cars, first race of the year, so I don't have them all in my head real clear, so I'm not even going to try. Just want to thank Roger for all the support and putting me in good equipment. So I want to thank Hoosier Tires too, because like I say, Matt was up there probably, I think he was as nervous as I was. He was doing all he could, pointing and poking and trying to tell me what to do, so thanks to him.
A round of applause once again, race fans. Shannon Buckingham, a winner of the ninth annual Cabin Fever 40.